Okay. So this is what I'm trying to show you guys on the haiku, and I probably should have showed you this first. This is average value, and I think that's an easier topic. So what is average value? It's essentially the average height of all of the heights inside an interval, okay? The formula for it is 1 over b minus a times the integral from a to b of f of x dx, okay? So let's just say the first assignment, page 463, number 1, okay? The graph of y equals 4x minus x squared in the interval 0 to 4, okay? See, what's happening here is there's a bunch of heights, okay? The height at 2 is 4, okay? That's the height of that rectangle. At 3, 4 times 3 is 12, 12 minus 9 is 3, that's the height. So you see all of the heights in here, there's an infinite amount of heights, that's the average value. Okay, we're going to find that average value by putting it right into the formula. So the formula is just going to do this. I'm going to put it in as 1 over 4 minus 0 times the integral from 0 to 4 of 4x minus x squared dx. Now this is a pretty simple problem. I would integrate inside, okay, and evaluate the integral before I multiply the 1/4. So if you want to practice this, put the 4 in here, and you're going to get 32 minus 64 thirds minus the 0. And if you work that out, you're going to get 32 thirds. Then you multiply the 1/4, and if you do that, you're going to get 8 thirds. What 8 thirds is the average of all of these heights inside the rectangle. There's an infinite amount of heights in this region. The average height is 8 thirds. So that's a pretty straightforward question. I probably should have done this first. Where is the average value? They might ask that in the homework, and all you got to do is you got to set the equation equal to 8 thirds. So I take the original equation and I set it equal to 8 thirds. So what I did is I multiplied both sides by 3 to get rid of the fraction. I brought it all over to one side, and I got this quadratic. I realized it was not factorable. So what I did was, you know, what you can do is you can use the quadratic formula, the QF, right? The quadratic formula will give you the two answers, and you're certainly welcome to do that. But I'm certainly okay with doing it the easier way, which would be to just graph them, set them equal to each other on your calculator, and use your graphing calculator, and you'll get the two answers. These are the x values, so 3.15 and, you know, 0.85, that's where the heights are 8 thirds. And that's what I'm trying to get at with this assignment. So I think you'll be all right. I mean, this assignment's pretty straightforward, and that's average value. I thought the second assignment I should have done now, the volume topic, is a pretty challenging one. So, you know, honestly, I'd suggest to do the average value first. There's two types of volume. Volume by disk. See, what's happening is that it's a three-dimensional solid. Like, take this x and y axis and put it out in front of you, right? And then you're going to take this solid, this region, and you're going to revolve it around the x axis, and you're going to essentially get kind of like a conical megaphone type shape, if you will. Think of it like as a three-dimensional problem. So it's not a flat plane-like area. It's almost going to be like a bugle in this case. Now, it's not lines as much as now it's circles, okay? And the calculus terminology is a disc, like a frisbee. There's an infinite amount of circles inside, and we're going to find the area of each circle, which is pi r squared, and we're going to put it into an integral. Now, the radius is going to be the distance from the x-axis to the function, which in this case is x squared. So that's why my integral is 0 to 2 of pi r squared, where r is x squared. Pull the pi out because it's a constant, And I'm essentially integrating the integral from 0 to 2 of x to the 4th power dx, which I could do on my own. And then when I get the answer, don't forget to put the pi back in. So that might be good practice. And with volume, it's cubic units, okay? The other type of volume is called a washer. And, you know, a washer, think of like a donut or a tire, okay? This three-dimensional shape is essentially going to have like a hole in it, if you will. So as I rotate it about the x-axis, it's almost like a hedge clipper, if you will, where you have an outer and an inner, an infinite amount of donuts, if you will, or tires going through the region from this case from 0 to 1. Okay? And to find the area of that shaded region, it's going to be the outer or the outer radius, which in this case is to the outer function, which is x, and then this is like the inner. Think of like an inner tube, if you will. The distance to the outside is the outer, and the distance to the inside is the inner. So this is going to get a little tricky, but that's why you get pi x squared minus pi x squared squared dx. Pull the pi out, and then this is something that you can work with. And then I would integrate it, and if you do that, you'll get the answer that they're looking for. Real quick, I'll do it for you. You guys know it's 1/3 x cubed minus 1/5 x to the 5th from 0 to 1, which would be 1/3 minus 1/5, which we know is going to be 3/15. 5/15 minus 3/15, which will give you an answer of 2/15, and then don't forget the pi. That's going to be the volume cubic units. So these are the basic disks and washers, which I'm going to work on more with you tomorrow and Friday. I think in the meantime, I would work on the average value. I think you'll have more success with that, and I think you'll have a little bit better, good start to the fourth marking period. All right, thanks.